Good morning. Cindy here in Central Texas, and today we are going to be talking about the crepe myrtle. Please excuse that loud cicada next to me. So I know that crepe myrtles are in every yard everywhere in Texas, and some people say, oh, you know, they're just, they're kind of tired. Let's look at something else. Well, I want you to see, this is a gorgeous new variety. It's a cultivar that is dwarf, and it's never gonna get any taller than this. This is about, oh, maybe it's 4 feet tall. And I'm gonna show you inside. You can see how it branches out. But look at these things. I am getting kind of hydrangea vibes from these, and they last all summer long, and they're deer resistant, so they're just fabulous. They can take anything that our Central Texas weather can send their way. They don't mind our difficult soil, and they're just fabulous. Now, they have to be in full sun to get these beautiful flowers. I was so happy to find this bank with all of these wonderful cultivars of crepe myrtle all around the parking lot. So this one is called a semi-dwarf, and I'm gonna put up a link so that you can see what all of the different names are. And of course, there's so many different colors. White is very, very popular. There's a red one right here, and there's some pink ones I'm gonna show you. And there's lavender. I mean, they come in just all so many beautiful colors. But I'm really excited because I can visualize this one in my yard and the first one I showed you, because they stay low and they can be a part of my landscape where they're low enough that I can imagine the flowers, you know, with other things in front of them. And the problem, which is not really a problem, with the standard size is in just, you know, they grow very fast, and in a short period of time, they're so tall that all you're looking at in your landscape is the trunk. So with these new cultivars, the semi-dwarf and the dwarf, this is what you see in your garden. Another really cool thing about the crepe myrtle is that you get four season interest. So in the spring, it flushes out with beautiful green leaves, and as the summer comes upon us, it's covered with these gorgeous, gorgeous white flowers, or pinks, or purples, or lavenders, or reds, and they stay all summer long. And then in the fall, the flowers fall off, and you get the leaves kind of turn a beautiful, oh, oranges and yellows and reds. They're just gorgeous. And then all the leaves fall off, so you really wouldn't want to put these by a swimming pool. But in the wintertime, you are left with the trunk sculpture. So this is the trunk, the multi-trunk of the semi-dwarf crepe myrtle. Isn't that beautiful? And if I get a little closer, you can see that this starts peeling, and what is left is this beautiful cinnamon colored bark. And of course it would do that all the way up. And there's very little that you would have to do in pruning these through the winter. You really don't prune anything but the very tips, and that's only if you want to. So another beautiful garden in my neighborhood has used the dwarf crepe myrtle all the way down. It is absolutely gorgeous. These are the semi-dwarf, so they're gonna stay about 10 feet tall, and they repeated the same color, so they're using the pink all the way down. They get full sun at some point during the day, so they are covered with the beautiful pink flowers. And aren't these just gorgeous? And below the crepe myrtles, they have grasses, they have a rock rose here that is just so pretty, spilling out onto the street. Look at those crepe myrtles though. And so these are very low maintenance. They're not going to be worrying about trying to keep them low and, you know, getting up on ladders and trimming, because this is as tall as they'll ever get. They've added some beautiful salvias. This might be Mystic Spires, Salvia Gregi. And look how pretty it is against the beautiful pink crepe myrtles. Isn't this gorgeous? Look at these clusters of beautiful pinks, and I'm sure the bees and all the pollinators and the hummingbirds just love it. These things, I want to get my hand here so you can see how big they are. Isn't that gorgeous? So I am so excited to discover the dwarf and semi-dwarf crepe myrtles. And some of you might be laughing like, oh my gosh, these have been around a long time. But I just didn't know. I thought people, you know, got up on ladders and trimmed the tall ones, but no. Look at this white Salvia gregi. Isn't that pretty? I'm gonna get some white. And it's so thick and fabulous. So pinks and purples and whites is repeated here. And this show will be here all summer long. All it needs is some water and voila. Isn't that gorgeous? So this is a wonderful example of a dwarf crepe myrtle. This is going to be about 7 to 8 feet tall. And in this variety, the flowers are lower, so they can be more a part of your landscaping if you're interested in having the flowers down more like at eye level. And she has it paired with some nandina, and over here I'll pan over to this side, she's got it with some of this beautiful creeping purple lantana. So the purples are just beautiful together. And this is a really, really drought tolerant, deer resistant. We have deer all over this neighborhood and it doesn't seem to be bothered at all. And I just absolutely love these beautiful, luscious clusters of the purple flowers. They're so pretty. So let's go look at some more. Another dramatic way to use crepe myrtles is to plant them in succession, repeating them. I like how they stayed with the same color all the way down. Aren't those just beautiful? And these are a variety that is semi-dwarf. So they're not going to be the really tall varieties. These are just kind of a medium height, so you don't have to do so much pruning. Aren't those pretty? And they just go all the way down the property. And look how gorgeous those beautiful clusters are. And they get these seed pods on them. And in the wintertime, those will turn brown and they'll look really great in the winter. These have the multiple trunks. They are just such a beautiful, showy plant tree. All the way down. Here is a beautiful medium-sized crepe myrtle. This one is about 12 feet tall. And this is just perfect for a smaller lot. You can really enjoy all of the flowers. They put this on the side of the home, so they've got a lot of interest, a lot of wow factor on this side of the house. And it's got a lot of space to really flush out and be beautiful. This is that kind of gorgeous, oh, dark fuchsia color that I just love. Now, they could have come in and limbed it up a little if they wanted, but they didn't want to. They just wanted the flowers to be all the way down to the ground, and it's just gorgeous. So crepe myrtle have a couple of problems when it comes to pests. One is powdery mildew, and another is aphids. So these new cultivars have been bred to be quite resistant to powdery mildew, which is just wonderful. And so these seem to look fabulous. I see no powdery mildew on any of these. So when you're picking out your new crepe myrtle to take home, check that it does have that new resistance added to it. And then another thing is those aphids. Aphids get on these things and chew on them and cause them to drip a sappy substance, and that sappy substance kind of turns the leaves black. As I'm looking though, I do not see one single aphid or problem on any of these. So they are doing great out here. So I really don't know the names of any of these dwarf and semi-dwarf, but look at this. Isn't she beautiful? And this is just the most bright cherry red. And the clusters are so pretty. And that's as tall as it'll ever get. There's this beautiful white one. Another red. And they're very different growth habits. And you can read about them before you buy them. So this one has kind of a weeping growth habit, which I really like that. And then this red one has more of a straight, growing straight up and down. Here's a little pink one. I don't think this one is getting enough sun, but really pretty. Look at that. So gorgeous. And this one is only about, oh, maybe this one is 4 feet tall, and that's as tall as it'll ever get. Well, thank you for watching today. I hope that I have inspired you to go out and get some dwarf or semi-dwarf crepe myrtles. I think these are going to be wonderful additions to our gardens. We've got the flowers down low where we can enjoy them all summer long. Then we've got that fall interest of the leaves changing colors to those gorgeous fall oranges and browns. And then, of course, we get that beautiful trunk in the wintertime. So get some crepe myrtles, and I will start showing you what I'm doing with them in my landscaping as time goes along. Thank you so much, and please comment below if you have tried some of these new cultivars.